Grace University, and these are our words.
I don't believe it's been. try to be perfect, but that's the worst perfect. Oh, let's go back to the start. It's hard to break the rules and copy the teasers. It's on the side of the things that I do.
Thank you.
the same. And every time we kiss, the world just goes away. Every time I miss you, you will always stay. They could only know what is that we can't show. This fast, I never thought that something like this could last. I want to shout it aloud. What is that we have found? And every time we kiss, the world just goes away. Every time I miss you, we'll always sidestep. They could only know.
My shoes quickly, and we'll explain why. Oh, I have to lower the mic.
We'd like to invite our friend Chris on stage to play drums for this one.
This next one is, I wrote this about 2 years ago. It's a parody about emo music. I dedicated it to my friend Erin, sitting right over there, because it's been her favorite song and we never performed it for like 2 years, so. Chris just needs to get his seat back that I stole to play piano. I'm wearing checkerboard Vans. I call them Spicolis. Character in Fast Times at Ridgemont High. I don't know where to go with that. It's an awesome movie. I don't know. It's called You Blogged All Over My Heart.
Yeah.
tell a story or should I?
We can both tell a story.
We're gonna have story time.
Yes. The name of our band is Orpheus and Eurydice, and it's a Greek myth. And,
okay, story so yeah. Greek myth. We both took a mythology class at university, so we both knew this. We're just complete nerds. But the story of Orpheus and Eurydice is that Orpheus is the greatest musician in the world, not to sound pompous, but it was either that or Apollo, who's the god of music, but whatever, I'm not in class. So Orpheus is the greatest musician in the world. He can stop time with his music and make everything on earth just stand still just to listen. And he meets a nymph named Eurydice, and they fall in love, and he's, you know, keep playing his music and everything, and they're all, you know, in love. And they get married, and on the day of their wedding, Eurydice gets bitten by a snake, and she dies. And Orpheus is completely depressed about this. He's stopped playing his music for everyone. So that goes on for a few years, and his buddies are like, hey, dude, you gotta get over it. We need your music back, because people get sad without your music. So Orpheus decides to try to get Eurydice back from the underworld, also known as Hades, but that's actually the god of the underworld. Learn something new every day. So he goes to the underworld, and Hades, what does Hades say? You take it from here.
Hades asks him, he's not just going to give her back to him. He's like, you have to perform a task for me. And he stole his bride from the above world, and she's always sad, and she misses the above world. And he said, make her smile. And so he sings her a song, and he makes her smile. And then he says, okay, you can have Eurydice, you can lead her back up to the real world, but she'll be right behind you, but don't look behind you, because if you look behind you, she'll disappear, and you'll never be able to see her again.
And this sounds harder than it seems, because one of the ways to the underworld is down this just eternally long path that seems like forever to get down, and that's where they have to go back out. So it's going to be very hard for him not to look back at his wife that he's lost and is depressed about. But continue.
Yes. So he's walking, and he kind of gets this inkling in the back and said, like, you know what? I'm probably walking up here by myself. Everybody's probably pointing and laughing, like, what the hell's he doing? But so then he turns around, and then she was there, and she just disappears. And so now he's lost her forever.
So if you're in that situation,
don't look back.
But he gets what's coming to him, because he's depressed again, and he won't play his music. So the crazy dancers of Dionysus, the god of festivals, called Maenads, they tear him apart.
Yep.
So I guess they go back to the underworld together, in some sort of terrible way.
Yeah, they're
but
both dead. So.
Yeah, it's really an unhappy name as I think about it. But there is potential. The next song is a cover. It's called "I" by Smashing Pumpkins. And before we thought of the name, we chose to play this song. And in retrospect, it kind of seems like it's about Orpheus and Eurydice. So now you know the story. Enjoy. Bye.
Turn to the way to heaven. Stairs, so go.
that's about as much as I will say in order to not embarrass her. Jay is some.
words that take me and erase me, and I'm painted black. Soon.